ओके सो वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड दिस पार्ट बट एट दैट टाइम द रिकॉर्डिंग वी आर नॉट स्टार्टेड बिकॉज ऑफ इंटरनेट प्रॉब्लम. सो आई एम रिपीटिंग आई एम रिकॉर्डिंग दिस वीडियो अगेन. ओके सो टुडे वील सी द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन हीट रिमूवल from the molding. Okay, so this is also important parameters for maintaining the quality of the product. Okay, so let us we'll start. Okay, so as we know that what we are doing, we are injecting the a plastic material in between the mold. Okay, and as we know that after that after injecting the material after the solidification of for the solidification of material, we need to make the cooling of the mold and that overall product. Okay, for solidification purposes. For that purposes, what we are doing, we are using the natural cooling. Natural cooling means due to natural air. Addition to that, what we are doing, we are circulating the water into that mold for the solidification purposes. Okay, so these two process we are doing. Okay. So, is it m hope my screen is visible? Just a second. Okay, so this is our point. Heat dissipation with the natural cooling. Okay, so heat dissipation with natural cooling. There are two things. First is natural cooling, and second one is forced cooling. Forced cooling means that water we are circulating into the mold for the solidification of the product. Okay. So these two parameters are very important. But one more thing is that heat dissipation with the natural cooling is not, we are not considering because we are cooling our molds and our we are making the solidification of product by using the only forced cooling. We are not considering the natural cooling, but this point is also for our syllabus. So keep in mind that. Okay. So heat dissipation with the natural cooling. Okay. Next point is a rate of heat removal by cooling circuit. Cooling circuit means whatever we are making the cooling. Okay, as you guys may have seen the tractor truck, in that for cooling of the engine body. Okay, engine block and engine body. If you guys may have seen, there is a water circulation is happened, and we are using the coolant to cooling purposes. The coolant is getting circulated out of the body of engine block. Okay, for the cooling purposes. Okay, so here also in molding process. Whatever the we have metallic plates for the upper mold portion and lower mold portion. So in upper mold also and in lower mold also, what we are doing, we have circulated the water in the mold body for the cooling purposes. Okay, and cooling and whatever yesterday also we have discussed that. The quality of the product is always depend on the how the solidification of the product is happening, how the cooling process, how the temperature control. These parameters are playing very important role. Okay, so here in the chapter we are going to calculate the heat dissipation rate. Heat dissipation rate means Q. Okay, heat dissipation rate means what we are going to calculate. We are going to calculate the Q. Okay, so while calculating the Q, following these parameters are very important, and they are playing important role. Okay, so let us see what are the important parameters. First one is mass of plastic material injected into the mold. Okay, so mass of plastic material means powder, plastic powder. Okay, so we can call it as a mass flow rate of the material. Mass flow rate of the material. Keep in mind that this is first parameter. Second one is latent heat of diffusion. This is kilojoule per kg. Okay, so latent heat of diffusion. This is also parameter is we required to calculate the heat dissipation rate. Next is specific heat. Space for space calculation of specific heat, we required we have unit kilojoule per kg Kelvin. After that, we have injection temperature of material in Kelvin. Injection temperature, generally we are means injection means that plastic powder initial temperature while injected into the mold. Okay, so keep in mind that. And temperature of mold means whatever the temperature of mold means, that metallic mold upper and lower, we should maintain the temperature of that mold before injecting the material into that. Okay, so we cannot inject the hot material into the cold, means atmospheric temperature molds. Why? Because that will affect on the quality of the product. To improve the quality of the product, so for that purposes, our mold, upper mold, lower mold, whole mold, molding, we need to make heated before injecting the plastic powder material into the mold. Okay, so this is also very important. Okay, so this is simple formula we have. This is simple formula we have to calculate the heat dissipation rate. This is simple formula we have. Okay, so what is formula? Q is equal to M into Cp into T2 minus T1 plus L. Okay, so where Cp means specific heat in kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Okay, so one more thing is that you should remember this formulae. Okay, formulae and these units. If you guys are not able to remember the statement of the problem, then by using these units, you guys can easily know that which is a latent heat, which is a specific heat. Okay, so this is a keep, which is mass flow rate, which is important. Okay, where C suffix P is specific heat, which is given in the kilo joule per kg Kelvin. M is a mass flow rate. T1 is the injection temperature of a material. T2 is the water supply temperature. and L is a latent heat. Only remember this formula and this unit, so that is important to calculate the heat dissipation rate. Okay, so now we'll go for the problem. What is problem? Problem number one. The plastic material injected in a mold with a rate of 55 kg per hour. Okay, with a rate of 55 kg per hour. What is this? This is a M. This is a M is given. Okay. The injected temperature as we discussed, this is a T1. Okay, so this is a injected temperature means T1. Whereas the mold is maintained at a temperature 22, this is a T2. This is a T2 by the cooling circuit. Find the rate of heat removal if the specific heat also given. Specific heat means Cp. And this is latent heat means L. Okay. So these all parameters we know. Just write down the given. In the given, write down this all parameters. Okay. As we know that this is a formula, we know that. Just we have what we have done. We have kept all this value into this formula and we get the Q. So this is a not a difficult. Okay. So you do one thing. You take your 2 minute time and you do one thing. You just solve it problem. Okay, so go for the second problem. Okay, so second problem is what is that? अ प्लास्टिक मटेरियल विथ 100 डिग्री टेम्परेचर मीन्स दिस इज अ टी वन मीन्स इनिशियल टेम्परेचर. ओके व्हाट एवर इनिशियल टेम्परेचर इज टी वन इज इंडक्टेड विथ अ रेट ऑफ सो रेट मीन्स एम. जस्ट रिमेम्बर दिस यूनिट्स बाय जस्ट ऑब्जर्विंग द यूनिट्स यू कैन इजिली फाइंड आउट द विच इज m, which is t1, which is t2, which is the c suffix p. Okay, you guys can easily find out this. If the latent heat of the fusion, latent is means l, this is l. Okay, so find out the temperature of water to be supplied for the cooling system means T2 we have to calculate second temperature. Okay, so we have to calculate the T2 and the rate of heat removal. Rate of heat removal means Q. Now in previous problem we have calculated. Okay, Q. And we have C suffix P means is given. Okay, so we specify it. Okay, so what we have done, we have initially we will give write down the all given data. Okay, so given data we have written. Okay, and what we have done, we have kept all this value here and we will get the T2 in Kelvin and we can convert it to degree Celsius. Okay, so this is how the problem is, very simple. Okay, so what is important here to keep all this value in the proper way. So this is also one of important things here. Okay, once you will keep all this value in the proper way, then there will not be any difficult while the solving the problem. For if for GATE examination also such a small problem for they are asking. So what you guys have to do, you have to just remember the one formula, that is it. This is Q is equal to M into C suffix P into T1 in minus T2 plus L. You have to keep this formula with its units in the proper way. So you guys will easily solve this problem. So, okay. So in GATE examination, what they are doing? They are just using the hurdle statement, hard statement. Okay, so that's it. So for that purposes, I'm telling you to only remember the units. Units are maybe very important. Whatever the statement, just observe the units, and from the units you will easily know that the specific, which is specific heat, which is latent heat, so like that. They are just giving the big statement, so like that, all these things. They are just forwarding same problem but writing in a different way. Okay, so that such things they are doing in the GATE examination. Okay, so this is also important here we have. Okay, so hope you guys understood this already. Also once we have completed this part, but due to recording issue, I am recording this video again. If you have any problem related to this issue, then you can freely contact to me. Okay, so next what we are going to calculate, calculation of weight of water to be circulated from the for cooling. Okay, so the effective cooling depend upon the rate of heat removal. Okay, and rate of heat removal is always depend on the how much quantity of water we are circulated per hour. Okay, so suppose we take the example, we are circulating the 5 kg water, and instead of 5 kg, in sometimes it will circulate the 7 kg, 8 kg water. Now, don't go for liter. Just remember now kg. Okay. So, if you take the example that suppose initially you were circulating the 5 kg water for the heat removal or cooling purposes, and after that you decided to circulate the 7 kg water per hour for the heat removal purposes. This is example of. Then what is the difference? Then what is the what you can say, how the quality of the product will change, how the surface finish will change, how the mechanical properties like toughness, tensile strength, compression strength of that product will get changed. Okay, and more important thing that how the solidification of the product that happen. Okay, so such important parameters we need to check while circulation of weight of water to be circulated for the cooling purposes. Okay, so we need to we'll go for the problems here because we don't have the derivation equation for the syllabus. Okay, so we have just simple this formula Q is equal to Km into T out minus T in, where Q is equal to rate of heat extracted. Okay. K is a constant to allow for the heat transfer efficiency. M is equal to weight of the water in kg per hour. T out means outlet water outlet temperature, and T in means water inlet temperature. Okay, so these are some parameters. Okay. Remember these parameters and this formula, okay, that both things are very important. Okay, so again I will repeat, what is formula? Q is equal to Km T out minus T in. Okay, so what is Q? Q means rate of heat extracted. Okay, K is a constant to allow for heat transfer efficiency. M is a weight of water kilo kg per hour. T out, water outlet temperature, and T in, water inlet temperature. Okay, so these are the parameters. Statement, we'll go for the problem. A plastic material with a temperature. Plastic material temperature means this is a T1. Is injected to a mold with 34 kg per minute. Means this is M, material injected. If you not understanding, just observe the units. The latent heat of a fusion of the material is latent heat means L. This is L. And the water supply temperature is water supply means T1, T in temperature. You put a T in or T1, whatever you want. This is a TN. An outlet means now we observe a T out. This is a T out. Is 90. If the specific heat is a specific heat means C suffix P. Is 1.68 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Then heat transfer efficiency constant is means K, constant K. Now we have discussed the constant, this is constant K. Then calculate the weight of water supplied per kg. Okay, so same as previously, initially write down the given things. So these are the given thing, just write down these things. Once I can read this statement and understood it all this thing. Okay, so just write down this all this thing and you go for the just formula. What is your formula? Okay, heat removed by the cooling is equal to heat extracted means gately heat. Okay, heat removed means la in previously we have calculated just means heat removed means heat extracted, of course. Okay, so and heat extracted, just equate this all this thing, and here you will get a M. You will get a M. Okay, so this such simple problems we have. Okay, so this is all about the third problem. Go for the fourth problem. Find the amount of water circulated per hour. If the water entering means this is TN. How much TN is? This is a 40 degree. And leaving means T out. This is T out. And if the total heat absorbed per hour, directly what they are given? They are directly given the Q. Initially, if you see here, they have not given the directly Q. If you see here, they have not given the heat extracted or heat removed. They have not given it. They have given M, L. Okay. So here they have given the directly term Q. After that, K is constant 30.5. And this is M we have to calculate. Q is equal to just write down this formula. Okay, so all just if you write the problem in the proper way, then You don't have any difficulty while solving this problem. Okay, so putting all this value, we have m. Okay, so this is also simple thing. You don't have any research, any here. So you can easily find out by putting the all things. Okay, so this is all about the problem. Okay. So hope you guys understood this, how to calculate the heat removed or heat absorbed means Q. And after that, we have seen the how to calculate the weight of the water. Okay, means M. Okay, so these two things are very important. For GATE examination, also for the university, if your university exam will be the MCQ type, then such problems, of course, they will ask. Okay, for next lecture, we'll complete the cooling time. Hope you guys have understood. Not difficult, okay. Remember this formula, for Q is equal to KM into T out minus T in. In some problems, the Q means rate of heat extracted is directly given. Or in some problems, you need to calculate it. Okay. And another formula is which is important. This is Q is equal to M into C suffix P into T1 minus T2 plus L. Okay. So here we are calculating the heat dissipation rate. Okay. Means Q. Okay, so that's that is about the whole session. Okay, so we'll stop here.